Hello dear students, I welcome all of you on this platform. Myself Dr. Praveen Gada and we have to discuss here BSc 5th semester paper number 15, that is microbial genetics. We start with your lecture, the introductory part of your syllabus, that is your syllabus or your paper is distributed in four different units and here is the overview of your syllabus. First unit, it has the properties of DNA and gene expression, that is molecular structure of DNA, different experiment performed by the scientists to prove DNA as a genetic material, molecular properties of DNA, replication mechanism, DNA replication mechanism, and different enzymes involved in the DNA replication mechanism. Post replication modification we have to discuss in first unit. Later in second unit we have to discuss about the gene expression. So basically we have to discuss about the silent feature of your genetic code. What is meant by genetic code? How they are responsible for different characteristics? We have to discuss. Then we have to discuss about the biological expression of gene, that is protein synthesis. Here we have to discuss transcription and translation mechanism. Also we have to discuss the regulation of gene expression by means of lac operon and arabinose operon mechanism. In third unit we have to discuss about the mutations. What is genetic mutation? Different types of mutation, whether is spontaneous mutation, induced mutation, we have to discuss here. Again we have to discuss about the different physical and chemical mutations which are responsible for carried out the mutation in particular host. Here in fourth unit we have to discuss about the bacterial recombination methods by means of transformation, conjugation and transduction. So different experiment performed by the scientist, their definitions and all about this recombination methods we have discussed in about fourth year. So today we have to start with your first unit, that is molecular structure of your DNA. So here from first unit we have to discuss molecular structure of DNA. What is meant by DNA? How it looks like? What its structure contain? So we have to discuss in first unit molecular structure. Later on we have to discuss the experiment to prove DNA as a genetic material. Different scientists carried out different experiment to prove the genetic information is transferred from the parents to the offspring by means of this DNA. And the DNA is a material which carry the information from parents to the offspring. So here we have to discuss different experiment. Semi-conservative mode of replication. Here in replication method we have to discuss the different methods of replication methods. DNA replication mechanism, how the replication is carried out. Molecular properties of DNA. Here another point, DNA, what are the molecular properties of DNA we have to discuss. Different enzymes involved in the DNA replication. It is the most important mechanism, that is DNA replication, and how the different enzymes are involved or responsible for to carry out the replication process. And later on we have to discuss about the post replication modification. So it is all about the first unit syllabus. So now let's start with your unit, that is molecular structure of DNA. The polynucleotide chain of very high molecular weight are called as nucleic acids. Here word nucleic acid, it suggests nucleic means that molecule or that substance is present probably in the nucleus. Normally the name itself suggests that nucleic acid are present in the nucleus, and acid stands for the acidic group. So polynucleotide chains of very high molecular weight. Polynucleotide means multiple single monomer is called as nucleotide, and if they are arranged in a long chain, that means polymers are called as polynucleotides. Of very high molecular weight are called as nucleic acids. So they are nothing but a part of DNA. Firstly, they are discovered by the Miescher in nucleus of the host cells. nucleic acids are first discovered by the scientist Fisher when he isolated or collected a sample from pus cells and he extracted the DNA from that pus cell. So they contain strong acid, hence name as nucleic acids. That molecule which he have isolated from the pus cells having the properties of strong acid, that's why they given a name to that molecule as a nucleic acids. Nucleic acid are polymers. Polymers are plural number, single are monomers and here are polymers. Their monomeric unit are called as nucleotides. Their monomeric unit, single, if there is presence of single nucleotide, it is called as monomer or single nucleotide. If they are arranged in a long chain or polynucleotide chain, that is called as polymers of nucleic acid, or that you can say polymeric nucleic acid chain. As name nucleic acid suggests, their location in the nuclei of the cells, already we have discussed, as the name nucleic, it means that molecule is present at the nucleus of the cell, that's why the name nucleic acid has given to that particular molecule. Acid, certain of them are also present in the cytoplasm. Apart from that nucleic acid name, certain molecule of that nucleic acid are also present or can found then in the cytoplasm of the cell. Nucleic acid are composed of the different molecules. What are they? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and phosphorus. These are the basic structural unit of this DNA or the RNA molecule. There are two different types of nucleic acid, DNA and RNA. So both are composed of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and phosphorus. So these are the basic structural and functional unit of nucleic acids. Nucleic acids are hereditary determinants of living organisms. It means they are hereditary determinant, means they are responsible to transfer the genetic information, that is hereditary character, from parents to the offspring, and that information is transferred by means of this DNA or genetic material is transferred by means of this nucleic acid from one generation to another generation. They are important biomolecule present in all organisms and viruses. They are most important biomolecule present in all organisms which are living. All organisms including viruses also. Nucleic acid is always present in all type of cells which are living. In case of viruses, they are also present, whether it is RNA or DNA. Viruses also contain nucleic acids. Viruses also contain nucleic acids, however, either contain DNA or in case of RNA, whether it is single-stranded DNA or single-stranded RNA or double-stranded or single-stranded RNA. Okay. These are vital substances so called as key of life or secrets of life. Normally, they are most important component of your cell, that's why they are called as key of life, because hereditary characteristics or genetic information is stored in the case of nucleic acid, that's why they are called as key of life or secret of life. What type of character are stored on the genetic nucleic acid, we can determine by means of this nucleic acid, that's why they are called as secret of life or key of life. DNA mainly found in chromatin of cell nucleus. DNA normally present in the chromatin of cell, which is present in the nucleus of the cell. Whereas most of RNA, about 90% of RNA, are present in the cell cytoplasm and a little 10% in the nucleus. About 90% of RNA are present in the cell cytoplasm, as they carry out or they play the important role in the or binded to the ribosomes and involved in this mechanism of protein synthesis. That's why they are present in the cytoplasm. There are two kinds of nucleic acids. There are two types of nucleic acid. What are they? One is deoxyribose nucleic acid, and another is ribose nucleic acid. Deoxyribose nucleic acid, that is, that means DNA, and ribose nucleic acid, that means RNA. So what are the biological importance of nucleic acids? While discussing about the DNA, as you can see, they are the key of life, secret of life, heredity characteristics. So we have to know about the, what are the biological importance of these nucleic acids or DNA or RNA. They are chemical basis of heredity, as we have already previously said. They are the key of life or secret of life. That's why they are also called as chemical basis of heredity. Normally, we can say a son look like his father or mother, or another means the baby look like his mother or father or its grandmother or grandfather. So that's why here these characteristics are transferred from one generation to another generation by means of this DNA. That's why they are called as chemical basis of heredity or basic heredity character molecule which can transfer genetic information from one generation to the another generation. They act as a reserve bank of genetic information. All the genetic information related to the characteristics and different genes are stored in the form of DNA. That's why they are called as the reserve bank of genetic information. So from that we can determine what are most, how they are important for the individual, as they are chemical basis of heredity and reserve bank of genetic information. Cellular functions are under control of DNA. All the cellular processes which are carried out in the cell are controlled by the DNA, as there are different mechanisms carried out in the cell, including start from the DNA replication or cell cycle to the DNA replication protein synthesis. Different mechanisms are carried out. So all these processes, how to trigger and how to stop all these mechanisms are carried out by the DNA, or all these mechanisms are controlled by the DNA. So we can say it is a mastermind of cell. All these processes are start or terminated by means of this DNA. What kind of signal has transmitted, it start the processes. Okay, so all these cellular processes are controlled by the DNA. They act as a carrier of chemical energy. Normally we can say body required energy in the form of ATP or NAD. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate, NAD nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. So they act as a carrier of chemical energy, as in the case of ATP there is a adenosine or adenine, it is a nucleotide which is present in case of ATP. That's why they are called as carrier of chemical energy. In case of NAD, there is also a adenine, or they are nothing but a form of nucleotides. That's why they are called as carrier of chemical energy. They also act as a component of cofactor, enzyme cofactor, in the form of NAD or FAD. So while discussing about the enzymology, we normally say enzyme and enzyme cofactor. Enzyme acts as a catalyst to carry out the, or to speed up the chemical rate of chemical process, while without the cofactor, that enzyme acts remain in the inactive form. So cofactor activate the enzyme so that enzyme carried out the reaction at fast rate or fastly. So here cofactor also, NAD and FAD, they are also a nothing but a nucleic acid or nucleotides. So major component most of the times for enzyme cofactor are NAD and FAD, they are nothing but a nucleotides. They also play an important role in carbohydrate metabolism, fatty acid metabolism and protein metabolism. So all these are the chemical processes which are normally carried out in the cell and which are having a most important to carry out the cellular metabolism normally. All these processes, all these, in case of all these processes, DNA or nucleic acid are most important factor, or they carry out a very important role. That's why they are very important or crucial molecule for the living system, as they have a most important biological importance in living system. So in next lecture we will discuss about the structural component of DNA and RNA, how they are arranged or how they bind to one another. We will discuss in the next lecture.